Naita atmano me tava katha subai kunthana. Naita atmano me tava katha subai kunthana. Sampriyate durita dushtamasa dutivram kamaturam harshashoka vayaishanartham tasmin katham tabagatim bimiswami dina tasmin katham tabagatim bimiswami dina Naitat manu me tavakatha su vaikuntanat sampriyati durita dushtamasad tibram kama turam harsasoka vayeshanartam tasmin katham tavagatim bimiswami dena. Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told to get in touch with that transcendental world. To get in touch with that aprakrita-jagat, there is one and single way. There is one and a single way. That is that transcendental sound vibration. Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told, to get in touch with that transcendental world, there is only one way, single way. That is called srauta-pantha. That is actually called srauta-pantha. To take shelter of transcendental sound vibration. That is the only way. Except that there is no other way open. Actually, srauta-pantha is the exact procedure through which you can attain realization, perfect realization. Otherwise, not possible. I am discussing about Srila Prahlada Maharaja Nrisimhadev topics. And that sloka also from 7th canto. It is Prahlada Maharaja speaking in front of Nrisimhadev Bhagavan. Prahlada Maharaja speaking in front of Nrisimhadev Bhagavan. O Prabhu, this my material mind cannot touch that transcendental one. Naitat mano me tava katha subhai kuntunat. First problem, Prahlada Maharaja speaking, this my material mind never like to hear a aprakrita harikatha. This my material mind never like to hear the transcendental aprakrita harikatha. Srauta-pantha I cannot follow properly. And there is no other way how I can reach you. Because I was full of kama, krodha. Prahlada Maharaj wanted to give us a nice lesson, teachings. That's why out of his humble attitude, expressing the mood in front of Nrisimhadev. Because we know, Nrisimha Maharaj cannot have that kind of bondage. But still he is speaking. Na etat mano me, this my material mind, tava kathasu, the transcendental glories of Supreme Lord, your harikatha, I don't like to hear. This is my condition. Naitat mano me tava kathasu vaikuntanata sampriyate. I never like to hear. Because I am full of kama, krodha, everything. Durita dushta kama turam. Sometime laughing, harsha shoka vayeshanartham. Sometime laughing, sometime crying. Shok, grief, expressing deep, you know. This way, I am in a position, I am in a very bad position. how to get out. That's why Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Goswami Prabhupada told same thing. Without srauta-pantha, there is no other way. Anyway, you will have to take yourself in such a place so that by hearing you can get realization. Otherwise, no way. Srauta-pantha. Prahlada Maharaja also speaking same thing. So, especially in Gauriya Math, we have Ekayan Pantha. 1-pointed devotion. All channelized. You cannot have different kind of opinions, nothing. But in Mahabharata we find Nasau Rishir Yasya Matam Nabhinyam. You cannot find a single Rishi whose opinion is not different from other Rishi. They have different kind of opinions, but we in Gauriya Math, we have Ekayan Padhati, 1-pointed devotion. We cannot have different kind of, you know, attitude. We cannot have different kind of mood and conception. We cannot have different kind of Siddhanta, nothing. Only we can depend upon Srauta-pantha, which is coming through one channel. And then we can come out successful. We cannot appreciate the procedure. We cannot appreciate the procedure adopted by Ekalabhya. You know the Ekalabhya from Mahabharata. We cannot accept, we cannot appreciate the procedure of Ekalabhya. Whereas Gurudev speaking, no, don't do this way. Gurudev ignore. But he forcefully wanted to get that kind of teachings, which is not at all satisfactory for Dronacharya to Gurudev. He cannot express satisfaction. That kind of procedure is not at all appreciated in Gauriya Math. We should follow Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur in total. Otherwise, you know, it's a big problem. Now you see, Prahlad Maharaj is one of those 12 Mahajan. Prahlad Maharaj is one of them. So Prahlad Maharaj going to give us a lesson, nice lesson. It is 6th Adhyay chapter, 7th canto, 6th chapter. Somehow in the school, in school, in Patsala, Sunday and Amarka Gurudev going for some other place, going for some other purpose somewhere, gone. And those boys, those who are, you know, admitted there in the school, they love Prahlad Maharaj very much. As and when they get a proper time, they don't like to play and waste their time. Usually they come in front of Prahlad Maharaj and sitting all around and asking questions very nicely. And Prahlad Maharaj also speaking about bhagavata-dharma. Prahlad Maharaj always speaking about bhagavata-dharma, what he and that kind of teachings he got from, you know, Naraji Maharaj, what he have received from Prahlad Maharaj. So this kind of teaching is excellent. So Prahlad Maharaj now, this time, in 6th chapter we find all Asura Vayas, all Asura Vayas, they are sitting around him and putting some question. So Prahlad Maharaj wanted to give answer nicely. Prahlad Maharaj now speaking. Prahlad Uvasi, Prahlad Uvacho, Kaumar Acharet Pragdharman Bhagavataniha, Durlabam Manusam Janmo, Tadapi Adhrubam Marthadam. Kumar Acharet Pragyo Dharman Bhagavataniha. This Bhagavad Dharma, who boys, you should follow, practice from very small age, when you are just adolescent. From then you will have to try. Because it is the Dharma of your Atma. Atma-dharma. It is called Atma-dharma. This Bhagavad Dharma is not related with your material mind and body, this society, nothing. It is an exclusive thing. Most exclusive thing, Bhagavad Dharma. Which you cannot expect from this bonded soul to fall. They cannot fall. And Prahlad Maharaj speaking, this life is really unstable. This life is really unstable, yet it is very important. Durlaban manusam janma. And after long and long time, somehow you can get this human body. Not always. 84 lakhs species of, jivatma traveling through different journey. After the somehow, by the mercy of, Supreme Lord, you are getting this body. Prahlad Maharaj speaking, Durlabam manusam janmo, tadapi adhrubam arthadam. Adhrubam mane, adhrubam not dhruva. Dhruva mean fixed, permanent. Adhrubam mean unstable. But yet, still, it is very important. Arthodam. Arthodam means it can give you unique result. Arthodam means non-dharma-attakam-makhya. Prahlad Maharaj means to say, it is arthodam. Arthodam means arthodo, means dan kora. Arthodo. It can give an exact meaning. Exact thing you can get. Excellent outcome. You can get. Adhrumam arthodam. And yathahi purushasyaha vishnu padopasarpanam yad eso sarva bhutanam priyo atmeswara surhit. Yathahi purushasya vishnu padopasarpanam. And you see, that's why in this life, vishnu seva. Vishnu Charan, to serve the lotus feet of Vishnu is excellent. You should do it. It is the exact prescription of Veda, Vedanta, Upanishad, everything. Maybe those Mayavadi can find some other meaning from Veda. I already told you they are not following Ekan Paddhati. So naturally they can have different kind of conception. But what it concerns to us? We are less interested about what kind of opinion, what kind of different opinion they are going to express in front of us, out of Shastra. So it is the exact, meaning of your life to engage yourself in Vishnu Seva. Because Vishnu is sitting inside all Jivatma. As pure Paramatma, you know already. Vishnu always sitting inside Paramatma, inside heart as Paramatma. All the time. So, Vishnu, this word, how coming? Sarva-bhuteshu vasati tu Vishnu. Sarva-bhut means everywhere. You cannot find a single place where Vishnu is not there. So then it is your 100% duty to serve Vishnu, all pervading Vishnu. It is your duty to serve all pervading Vishnu. Vishnu is every pervading Vishnu. Because nothing is there except Vishnu. The only and single Tattva. The only and single Tattva which is expressed in front of you in diversified way. Which is expressed in front of you diversified way by the mercy of Maya. But actually, Adhyayagan Tattva, Badanti Tattva Jnanam, Badanti Tattva Jnanam, Badanti Tattva Jnanam, Jad Adhyayam. Only that Adhyayagan Tattva. Now, also, Prahlad Maharaja advising, look, my friends, actually, it is the usual habit of all you know jivatma to search for happiness. It is the usual habit of all jivatma, knowingly or unknowingly, they are searching happiness. But they actually don't know the actual meaning of happiness. They don't know the actual meaning of happiness. They don't know the actual meaning of happiness. Though they are searching for happiness, but they don't know the actual definition of happiness. Like a blind man searching here these fishes. All human being actually, all jivatma, they are actually blind. Because one screen of Maya is there. One screen of Maya is there, you cannot see as it is. They cannot understand the actual happiness is there inside you. Amrita, the nectar, is there inside your heart. Senanto amritasya putraha. In Upanishad you can find Veda. So you see, Prahlad Maharaja now giving this argument, you see, who my friends, Sukham Aindriyakam Daitya Dehu Yogena Dehinam. Sukham Aindriyakam Daitya Dehu Yogena Dehinam Sarvatra Labhati Daivad Yathadukham Mayatnataha. If you have the chance to look inside your heart and search by the mercy of Gurudev, you can find, oh my God, I was searching Amrita outside. It is already there inside me. In Upanishad, one sloka is there. Atma va are drashtavyo sutavyo nididhyasitavyo. It is for Atma. You are loving others. Everyone, if mother loving son, son loving father, father loving son, husband loving wife, wife loving husband. This way everywhere you can, any kind of love appear for what? For what you are getting some minimum of this material life. Why? Because of Maya. Otherwise, who is going to put so much energy to maintain family? They are getting some rasa, enjoyment. From morning to night, working. Hard working, they are putting energy to get that ananda. But anandam brahma. In Upanishad you can find Anandam Brahma, Vedanta. Brahma is Ananda. Why you are searching Ananda, happiness? Because inside your heart there is this Ananda. You also Brahma, Brahma in the sense, Brahma in the sense, not Brahma equal to you. Brahma. Not equal to you, but Brahma, you have chitkon, You have the same quality that your Atma is there inside your body. It's of same quality as Brahma is. Because you are from Brahma. You are from Brahma, by Brahma. Eh? So, everything. Okay. So, sukham indriyakam daitya deho yogena dehinam sarvatra labhate daivad yatha dukham ajatnata. Prahladma speaking, ho friends, nobody want to suffer. Nobody never want to suffer. Why? Nobody want to suffer because suffering is not there. Nobody want to suffer. Mind it. Nobody want to suffer. You want to suffer? No. You want to enjoy, get ananda. But why then suffering coming in your life to put you in trouble? Why you are suffering? Then why you are suffering? Whereas you never want, expect. Because according to your past activities, it's a must. Because according to your past activities, it's a must. Though you are not expecting, but still it is a must. You are going to accept it. You are bound to accept it. You are bound to accept. So nobody can avoid this. So, oh my friends, in any journey, maybe you are coming in the form of a pig, baraha, pig. In that case, you can get different kind of enjoyment. If you are getting nice stool, then you can enjoy, ha, today my life is very good. Because I am getting new stool, very nice. Yes. Those who are pig, they are laughing, dancing. Ah, today a lot of, bishta, stool I am getting to enjoy. Today's life is a big feast today. Yes. And a tiger, if getting one, animal, then his blood and flesh, a big utsav feast today. They say all Jivatma, they are enjoying according to their own estimation, according to their own nature. You are feeling nice here in Mayapur, hearing Harikatha, you all. Maybe a man from your country, or maybe your sister or brother, like to go to hotel to dance and drink. Why? What we can do? Twin brother, one become police, one become thief. We have nothing to do. You have no controlling over anybody. You have no controlling at all. You have no controlling, you have no bearing. The total system is arranged in such a way, you are bound to obey the Supreme Lord. Knowingly or unknowingly. If you have submission, then okay, Supreme Lord can accept you. You have no submission, then you will have to suffer. Mame boje prapadante maya metam tarantite. Those who are having submission unto my lotus feet, only they can cut this maya and go. What to do? So any journey, if you are entering the snack, if you become snack next life, if you become tiger next life, if you become cow next life, who can say what situation you can meet with next life? That depends upon your present activities, what you are doing. But it is in a prayer by all Gauriyas, we, under the guidance of Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Pashupakki hoye thaki sarve sargeba niroye, Tava bhakti rahu bhakti vinodihita. Hey Bhaktivinoda Thakur praying. Hey Prabhu, I can enter into any journey. Maybe who can say? According to my activities. Avasvameva bhaktavya. Krita karmam subha subham. Good and bad activities you are, you know, doing every day and night, every day. But if your total life is regulated by a pure devotee, Shuddha Vaishnava Guru, then we cannot expect that you can do some fruitive activity. We cannot expect that you can do some fruitive activities. We cannot expect, because you are, if you are totally regulated by Shuddha Guru Vaishnava, then there is no question of any result of your activities. So we like to get bhakti. Prahlad Maharaj this way, this giving this Bhagavat Tattva Vigyan, Prahlad Maharaj speaking. So, oh my friends, in any life, you are, suppose you are going to leave this body, take another body, another body, another, who can say? But who, my friends? It's all the same. In any life, you anyway you are going to enjoy and suffer. Anyway you are going to enjoy, sometime enjoy, sometime suffering can come. It's a must. So I would suggest, Prahlada speaking, so I would suggest you, who, my friends, tat prayaso na kartabbo yat yato ayur vayoho param. Prahlada speaking, it is my suggestion, oh friends, not to waste your life in this way. Tat prayaso na kartabbo yato ayur vayoho param. This way you can lose your, you know, life. Paramayu, you know, lifespan. And this way, tat prayasana kartabhyo yato ayurvayoha param. When I was, you know, almost a boy, small boy, that's why one news came in newspaper. Very nice news. What news? One news came, very nice news, that one barber, no, he was cutting here. He's very poor. He is in Taliganj, here in Calcutta. Somehow he got one, you know, lottery ticket, you know, 1 crore rupees. He is just cutting here, somehow managing life. On that day, as a barber, getting very small amount. At present, 60 rupees, 100 rupees. That time only 25 paisa. 25 paisa. Bus fare, 25, I can remember, 7 paisa, 7 paisa, only 7 paisa, in tram, bus, very small amount. But when that, you know, Baba came to know, oh, I'm getting 1 crore rupees prize, he is so excitement, heart fell. So excitement coming, heart fell and died. And who is going to enjoy the 1 crore rupees that you are getting? Yeah? I can give 1 or 3 examples, one by one. You can, you know, think over and again. Oh my God. Yes. One day one news came, actually 32 years back. In Dalhousie, I went. And a father of my friend, Gujarati, is speaking. One nice news came here, you see. What news? But one man in England, very, very rich man, billions of pounds. He has no relation. Then no wife, no children, no relative, nothing. Only have one pet dog, very nice, Tommy. In newspaper it came, while he is dying, before that he make one will, in which you keep all property in the name of that dog. I was laughing. I was thinking, Navin Bhai, try to think over again. Who is going to write all property in the name of dog? So huge property. I don't know what a kind of dog he himself is. He is a big dog. That's why he is writing all in the name of dog. He don't find any application where to put money, how to spend money. He is writing all in the name of that pet dog. See the situation. Another example. I used to go to a medicine company before, long ago. They are very rich. Behala. Yes. And they actually, it's a limited company, very rich man there. And their house in Alipur, Calcutta, New Alipur. In their house, they are taking care of 7 dogs from different countries. One dog from Switzerland, one dog from India, one dog from America, maybe different country. Japan, different kind of dogs, 7 kind of dogs. They engaging 7 teachers for dog to take care, to give lesson. And also doctors and everything there, maid servant taking care. And for each dog, different kind of, menu, you know? What do you like? What? Cooking. So they are spending billions of dollars for dog. Now it is my question. You see the luck of that dog. Who is enjoying more than a poor man? A poor man, his baby is there, I have seen. Practically in my life, I used to go to Indian Institute of Technology, Kharagpur. One day I was standing in station, I see one poor Mataji. A new baby, small, nothing to feed him, very poor. He's getting some extract of rice, pan, we say. Extract of, after boiling, some, with salt, no milk is there, with spoon, putting. I was crying, what situation? According to his past activities, that boy suffering this way, mother suffering this way, the dog enjoying that way. In a dog show, one dog become enjoying first prize, 50 lakhs rupees, dog show. I say, what is the luck of that dog? Oh God, you see, I give 3-5 examples. Out of that, you must settle down your mind. The enjoyment is not your goal. In Hindi, we find one word, khao, pio, jio, in Hindi. Mane, you drink, take rest, and enjoy your life. In English, we say, enjoy your life. Those are material people, they're saying, enjoy your life, enjoy yourself. What do you mean by enjoy yourself? Idiot. Samimara used to say, a cats and dogs society. I know your civilization. Samimara used to say, I know your civilization. It is cats and dogs society. You want to prove that you are civilized? In every fraction of a second I can prove your life is not better than a dog. Maybe you can become angry with me. No dedication, no nothing, only enjoyment. So Prahlada Maharaja suggesting, Prahlada Maharaja speaking, oh my friends, I would suggest that don't waste your time. Don't waste your time, life is most, valuable. Tat prayaso na kartavya yato ayur vayoho param. Na tatha bindati khemam mukunda charanambujam. But if you can serve the lotus feet of Vishnu, I mean Mukunda, you can get the total solution, exact solution you can get. I was sorry to speak, that we cannot do bhajan properly. Always we are busy with our material body and mind and, you know, these, that. Oh, so much trouble. Now, Prahlad Maharaj giving one by one example. Oh, my friends, you see, when one man talking with wife very secretly in a lonely place, they enjoying this rasa, material rasa. They are joking with each other. Wife joking with husband, husband joking with wife. Prahlad Maharaj speaking this way, you see. They are getting rasa, right? Sure, they are getting rasa, but that is material rasa. Somehow, directly or indirectly, whole world enjoying rasa, right or not? Directly or indirectly, whole world enjoying rasa. I already told, one pig, he is also enjoying rasa. One ant, he is also enjoying rasa. One mosquito, also enjoying rasa. Huh? Enjoying new blood. If you want to, you can fly. I like to live long, to take new blood from new body. This is the situation of this, you know, material world. So you see, Palladma speaking, Tato yate to kusalaha khyamayo bhavamasritaha sariram purusam javan na vipaddeta puskalam. This body is most unstable, anytime you can die. So better, to get the highest benefit, you concentrate on your mind, onto the lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava, and in ultimate outcome, I am giving this meaning. Tato yate to kusala kshemayo bhavamasritaha sariram purusham javadna vipaddeta puskalam. So long you are going to maintain your body, you can get your body on this material planet. So better you do bhajan. Nice. Now, Prahlad Maharaj actually in a very joking mood, very nice, very serious. But in a very, you know, speaking, you see the condition of the material world. Those men, they are talking with wife very secretly in a very enjoying mood. It is also one kind of rasa. Also rasa, but jara rasa, material rasa. Prahlad Maharaj speaking very nicely. Katham priyaya anukampitaya sangyam rahasyam ruchiranscha mantran. Katham priyaya anukampitaya sangyam rahasyam ruchiranscha mantran. When you meet your wife after a whole day of, whole day you are running here and there. When you come back at home, you are talking with wife very secretly. It's one kind of nice enjoyment. Katham priyaya anukampitaya sangyam rahasyam ruchiranscha mantran sruhit sutat sneho hasito sisunam kalaksharanam anurakta chitta. Why you are putting so much energy? Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, in kirtan, you must learn kirtan. You must do kirtan. Repeatedly I am speaking. Nobody doing kirtan properly. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, I am putting energy for this material world, mane sansar, like ass. Gardhavya rupaya, not ass. Ass, gada, donkey, like a donkey. I am putting all energy. I am whole day and night putting energy like a donkey, but getting no result. Kisher sansar ei chhayabaji pay. Kisher sansar ye ei chhayabaji pay. Ihate mamata kori bitha din jay. It's like a light, you know, magical light spell. Like, you know, at present, if you are going to watch one theater, you know, a stage show, a light is so technology, Through light they can prove that train going. Ah, train going. Light, light. Light technology is so high at present. In sky, lightning, ding, ding, light. Through light they can. A train going through track, exactly. Light, light. Bhaktivinoda Thakur was speaking, it's just a magic spell of light. You know, like black magic, jadu. I'm putting all energy and losing all my life. After a whole day, I'm coming back. So much energy I'm putting. When after a whole day I'm coming back, when my small boy coming into a papa, papa, then I take in lap and kiss. All my energy gone. A solution. One small boy, when father coming back from office, a small boy coming, papa, papa, he take in lap and kiss him. All energy solution done. He's just tired. Again he revived, get all energy back. He is kissing his small boy. Very nice. This kind of enjoyment, this material world enjoying, you see. After coming back from office, your wife giving you a, you know, one glass of, you know, hot tea. Very nice hot tea. Now you are very happy. Serving you. Wife serving you? Or Mayadevi serving you? Who? Wife serving you? No wife. Actually, Mayadevi serving you. It's Mayadevi. You see, this way actually, those bonded soul, they cannot have any controlling over their sense organ. They are like crazy man. Sometimes running there, in Bombay you can find people, they are going for, you know, outing, very nice enjoyment. When? Night 12 o'clock. In Bombay you can go, in Juhu Beach, Sea Beach. Night time 12 o'clock they are going to enjoy. And when they take rest around after 2 o'clock or 3 o'clock. And they get up 9 o'clock. This is their life. You can go and watch. I am speaking from my personal experience. Night time 12 o'clock, 11, 12, they are going with children, everything at the bank of Juhu Beach. Enjoy. After that, they are taking, like an animal, they are taking some, you know, food. They are in the Sea Beach Hotel. Egg, you know, biryani, they are taking egg, meat, everything. After that, they come back. After they are night time, they are taking rest more, late at night. Morning time, they get up 9 o'clock. This way they are enjoying, they think they are enjoying their life. So, each and everybody you can find, each of them have separate kind of conception. But we want to follow one and unique way, that is srauta-pantha. Prahlada Maharaja speaking, oh my friends, to worship Supreme Lord is not a big problem. If you want to worship sun god, moon god, Shankar, Durga, you can go. But for Supreme Lord, almost within no time you can worship, because he is Supreme Lord sitting inside yourself. Inside your body. Nahi achyutam prinayato bhavayaso suratmaja atmatat sarvabhutanam siddhitat iya sarvata. Because Supreme Lord is omnipresent. Everywhere you can find. We can prove. Hiranyakashipu Vinaya, hey! You saying your Supreme Lord everywhere. Is here in this pillar? Yes, is there. Well, he then big fist. then break. And Nrisimhadev coming out. What Siddhanta written there? What Siddhanta written there? Satyam vidhatum nijavitta bhasitam. To prove that my servant can never speak lie. Nrisimhadev coming out. Yes. Each and everywhere, all dust particle, you can get Supreme Lord. Especially you are lucky, who can say, while you are going to take bath in Ganga, going to market, who can say? By air flow, maybe you are getting the dust particle of Nityananda, who can say? All dust particle here? Who can say, I am not going to get the dust particle of Gauranga Mahaprabhu, who can say? Can you put guarantee? So how lucky you are? Maybe nine crores of people here, whole over the whole world. But you are the luckiest personality, I would say. Sivas Pandit, Gadadhar Pandit, Pundari Vidyanidhi, Advaita Gosai, who can say you are not going to get that dust particle on your head? Who can say? No worry, there's no such. You are very lucky. But you cannot calculate. You have to sit and calculate how lucky I am really. It is my duty to show the way. It is my duty to show the way how you can get your eyes back. So that you can see as it is. Under the guidance of Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Prabhupada, under the guidance of Kesava Goswami Maharaj, Bhakti Pramodpuri Goswami Maharaj, it is my duty to open your eyes and see what is there. Why you are feeling sorry? You should enjoy. This family life is very good. I don't want to make you a cheater. Take sannyas and go and cheat people. Idiot number one. It's good. You stay here and do secret bhajan. Don't try to prove that you are a big devotee. Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj became very angry. Such, you know, Gaurakishore Babaji Maharaj speaking, don't try to prove that you are a big devotee. Don't try to prove. You cannot cheat me. Never. This way you see, Prahlada Maharaj speaking, Nahi achyutam pranayato, to satisfy achyuta, to satisfy achyuta Krishna, are not a big matter. You need not put so much energy. It's already there inside you, just concentrate and love. It's a big fallacy, the only friend there in your life, it's a big fallacy, you are so full. The only friend there inside your body is that Paramatma, Supreme Lord. And those who are the devotees of Supreme Lord, they are also same Tattva, non-different from Supreme Lord. Bhagavat Tattva is all together. Dhamma, Nama, you know, Supreme Lord Himself and, you know, Parikar, Paraparnalia, all together one Tattva. Badanti tattva vidam satyam jad gyanam adyam brahmeti paramatmeti bhagavaniti sabdate. The unique tattva, the unique tattva, unbeaten, unparalleled. You have to feel, realize that tattva. Why you are coming to Mayapur? What reason? To enjoy taking ice cream? Eh? Is Congress student? Why? This way you see, Supreme Lord is everywhere. There is a big fallacy that you are making friends with outside people. That's why you are going to die. Whereas your genuine friend, permanent friend, is there inside your body. You never like to make any friendship with Supreme Lord. You like to make friendship with some other, you know. Hey, say, it's a matter of joke. It's a matter of joke, you see. Now, I already told, so again I can remind you this factor. Those small boys, I mean the friends of Prahlad Maharaj, now asking, Prahlad, you, Prahlad, in front of Prahlad Maharaj, those boys, you know, friends of Prahlad Maharaj asking, Prahlad, you and we all, reading in same school, same patsala, same teaching, but where from you are, you know, gaining that kind of, you know, where from you are getting that kind of nice teaching? We don't know. Then Prahlad Maharaj going back to his past history. Well, here, oh my friends, long ago my father took decision to go to Mandarachalan Parva to do perform astrid and penance a big way. For a long time he is not coming back. My mother was pregnant. That time I was there inside my mother's womb. Indra came to arrest my mother. Somehow she was free from that bondage by the instruction of Naraji Maharaj, big sadhu. I am speaking in gist, I already told you, I am not going to, no time actually. Ocean of nectar. That time Indra Maharaj, Devasi, Indra Maharaj protecting my mother and speaking all Bhagavatam Vigyan. I was there inside the womb of my mother by the mercy of Naraji Maharaj. I was able to catch all the teachings of Naraji Maharaj. It's wondering. I was sitting inside the, you know, womb of my mother, but still, by the mercy of Naraji Maharaj, I could, you know, realize all the teaching. I could, you know, accept all the teachings. I could digest all the teachings by Naraji Maharaj. And someday my father came back, all big problem, fighting. Asuras, they are always in problem by demigods. Demigods, they are always finding unstable situation. Sometimes demons, they are attacking heavenly planet. This way, you see. Now, actually, how to get that kind of feeling? Who my boys? Who my friends? How to get that kind of feeling? Paratma speaking, he says, only an unique way. And Gita also, Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking, tadviddhi panipatena paripeshnana sevaya upadekshanti te jnanam jnaninas tatta darshinaha. Oh Arjun, my friend, you will have to serve a very unique sadhu, very realized soul. Krishna speak giving this. So you have to serve. Without which you cannot expect that you can get maturity. You cannot expect. Tad-biddhi means know it for sure. Tad-biddhi panipathena paripashnena sevaya. Panipathena mana? Actually you will have to surrender, 100% surrender. Panipat means prakishto pranati. Pranati means pranam. Dandavat pranam maybe. But maybe you are copper, not paying proper dandavat. So that's why Krishna is speaking this term. Tadbiddhi noit pasya pranipatena pro. Pro means it is increasing the power of that word. Pro, para, apo, onu, odhi. Gammate, adigammate, prapate, you see? This way you can, an extra power you can get with the prefix. It's called prefix. English also there. Rehabilitation. This kind of word you can find. So nice. Action and reaction. Reaction. Action is one word. If you fix re, then word, the meaning changing. This way, tadviddhi panipatheno. You will have to pay dandavat, but you, dandavat mean self-submission. 100%. Paripathena, paripasana. Now you are putting question in front of Gurudev. From heart. To save yourself. What is my situation? How to save myself? Like Parikshit Maharaj putting in front of Sukhdev. Not that to test. Not that to test Gurudev. How much, how long he is knowing. How much he is knowing. Let me test how big Pandit he is. Oh, he is knowing nothing. This is not actually paripasana. Paripasana means a question coming forward from heart to save yourself. Crying and crying, save me. How to get relief from this material torture? Panipat, paripasana. And sevaya means you will have to serve that realized soul. Sadhu, Guru, Vaishnava. Without serving Gurudev, without serving Guru Vaishnav, I cannot give direct feeling. Not possible. You cannot give direct feeling. Maybe your brain is very high, you're very powerful. Maybe your brain is very powerful, you can grasp all philosophy from me. But direct realization, where from you can get? Direct realization? Where from you? You can get so many speakers. If you are really enjoying Kipa of Nityananda, you can arrest readily. He is speaking out of his own proficiency. He is not speaking actual Harikatha. Another you can hear, Paramahansa Sridhar Goswami speaking very lightly. Then you can realize he is speaking from heart. Bhakti Puri Goswami Maharaj in old age, sitting in bed this way, speaking Harikatha. But his speech is you coming from heart. And that speaker in Vrindavan, he wants to give you enjoyment. He is a speaker, platform speaker. He is not speaking from heart. Follow? Actually, any words spoken by Gaurgisar Babaji Maharaj is Harikatha. The whole day you are speaking, ba 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 ba. It is not Harikatha. All material talking. Any speech by any realized soul, any time, any moment, is Harikatha. They are not speaking all rubbish. They are less interested about their personal interest. So now Prahlad Maharaj is speaking same advice. You see, Guru Susya Saya Bhaktya Sarbo Labhar Panena Cha Sangena Sadhu Bhaktyanam Isho Mishwarara Dhanena Cha. What speaking, Prahlad Maharaj? Guru Susya, you have to serve Gurudev. Seva means to seek the satisfaction of your Gurudev. Seva means, if I like to serve my Gurudev, mean I like to seek the satisfaction of Gurudev. I like to serve Nityananda, mean to seek the satisfaction of Nityananda. Be careful. Oh, Maharaj, I am serving Gurudev. What kind of service you are doing? Eh? What service you are doing? Gurudev is not serving. I give a nice example. One foolish person, devotee, so-called devotee, not devotee. In village, long, remote village. One day Gurudev coming. In, one grihastha devotee of Gurudev, going to receive Gurudev. That time you see, a December, month of December, a beating cold. Very deep cold. Then Shisha, that disciple, making hot water to wash the lotus feet of Gurudev. It's nice, quite natural. Gurudev feeling comfortable. After they putting in chair, allow, give garland, okay. And one foolish person is watching, making hot water, washing the leg. Oh, this is seva. And after long time, again Gurudev coming, not in his house, in this foolish house. Foolish man, devotee, so-called devotee. He is sitting, Gurudev, Gurudev coming, in the month of Vaishak, too hot. He is making hot water and putting a... Gurudev, what you are doing? Why? I am washing. You are giving hot water? Why? I saw. Through hot water, it is the rule. Idiot. Go! So, they don't understand. In the month of Vaishak, he is making jaishta, too much hot. He is getting hot water for Gurudev to wash his lotus feet. This is kind of seva I am doing. So foolish. Seva means to seek the satisfaction of Guru Vaishnava and, you know, Bhagavan. Not according to your whimsical attitude, you cannot do seva. Be careful. Anywhere you go, in your previous home, anywhere, you must speak this Siddhanta nicely. Perfect Siddhanta you must speak. So that all other people can also grow that kind of Siddhanta inside their heart. They can develop pure bhakti. Be careful. Guru Sushaya Bhaktya Sarvulabhar Panenacha. Guru Sushaya Vaino serving Gurudev. Very nicely. Bhaktya, out of devotion, perfect devotion. You are serving Gurudev. And what you are getting in your life, all you are offering to Gurudev. Sarvo Labhar Panenacha. What kind of benefit you are giving, all giving to Gurudev. Suppose you are giving high honor to me, but you cannot believe. I am not taking honor from anybody. No garland for nobody. I give everything to my Gurudev. That's why it cannot touch. It cannot touch me. I am not accepting, not nothing. What you give, I offer. This is a technique of bhajan. So, sarvo labhar panena cha, what you gain, la pujapati, anything can come in your life. But all you should give, offer unto lotus feet of your Gurudev. You cannot enjoy. If you are going to enjoy la puja patishtha kamini kanchan, then you are yoshit sangha, you are doing yoshit sangha. I already explained this point, big way. So, guru susya saya bhaktya sarva labhar panena cha sangena sadhu bhaktyanam ishwar aradhanena cha. Also, you have to serve Gurudev and Ishwar this way. Then you can cut all this material bondage. Harihi sarveshu bhuteshu Bhagavan. Bhagavan. Is painting mistake, I think. Harihi sarveshu bhuteshu Bhagavan ananta Ishwaraha. Iti bhutani manasva kamaistvai sadhu manet. You see, because Supreme Lord is everywhere, omnipresent, you see. And also you will have to honor all jiva. You cannot put them in trouble. You should not put any jivatma in trouble. You should realize the Supreme Lord is also there inside monkey. Supreme Lord is also there in this, you know, insect. Supreme Lord is also there inside dog. You cannot give, you know, udveg. Udveg means trouble to anybody. This way you have to do bhajan nicely, then gradually you can feel, you know, everything is unstable, my friends. Everything unstable. Now, actually, in front of, you know, Hiranyakasipu, Prahlada Maharaja again, you know, coming. Hiranyakasipu now very much fed up. Very much fed up. Because he is taking control, getting control over this whole world, universe. So powerful. But cannot control the small boy. always coming in front of you and speaking all about Hari Bhakti. Whenever I am putting any question, speaking about devotion, devotional service of Supreme Lord, giving all nice advanced thing about Bhagavata Tattva Vigyan, what's that? What is the medicine I can apply for this small boy? Hey! Where from you are learning? That Hari is everywhere. You know? How you are getting so, you know, power? Why you are not fearing me? Who maintaining you? Who protect you? Who protecting the Supreme Lord, who is protecting you and everybody, he is protecting you. Stop! I don't like to hear nonsense. I am protected by that super personality. Who is protecting you? Who is protecting everybody? Stop! I don't like to hear that. Where is your Supreme Lord? Everywhere. Very politely. Everywhere. He's taking everywhere. Everywhere? Here in this pillar also? Why I cannot see? Also he's there. Then you see, provide a big feast, you see. First of all, Hiranyakasipu wanted to abuse that small boy. Big way. He durvinito, mandatmano kulo, he the karanam. You are there, you know? Kulo vedakara, kulo vedakaradhama, stabdam machasano udhritto neshetuadda jamakshayam. I like to kill you. You actually not, never obey me. Hey durvinito, mandatmana, your brain has gone out of order. You have no submission unto my lotus feet. Durvinito, never obey me. You are the worst personality in my whole destiny. In family, hereditary pair, hereditary, you know, line, you are the worst one. Because he is doing Krishna Bhakti. Come on. In my whole, you know, family line, you know, you are the worst one. For you, I am losing all my honor, everything. I am going to kill you now. Let me see who is going to protect you. Prahlad Maharaj is zero, without any tension. Prahlad Maharaj, without any tension, standing in front of Hiranyakasipu. Because Prahlad Maharaj is, you know, 100% believe in Supreme. You should have 100% belief. Guru, Vaishnava and Supreme Lord. Otherwise you cannot come out successful. 100% belief. Not 0.00001% disbelief. Na kevalam me bhavatascho rajan savai balam bali nancha paresham. That power protecting me. For whom you are getting power? I am getting everybody. Then, Prahlad Maharaj, actually, Prahlad Maharaj, you know, speaking his very, very humble way. But Hiranyakasipu become very angry, very, very. So, aham vikottamanasya siraha kayad haramite. Gopayeta haristvaddo jaste saranamipshitam. Jaste saranamipshitam. You want to take shelter of that Hari? Your brain gone out of order. You are speaking a lot. Speaking big, big thing. Now let me see. Open his sword. I am going to cut your head. Let me see who is going to protect you. Open. So aham bikottha manasya siraha kaya dharamite. I am going to cut your body from you. Cut your head from your body. Let me see who is going to save you. Where is Hari? Then after that speaking, My Hari is everywhere. In this pillar also. And provide a feast, big feast. Then, satyam vidhatum nijavitta bhasitam vyaptincha sarvi bhuteshu akhilesu chvatmanah adrishyatvat bhuta rupa madbhahana stambe sabayam na mrigam na manusham. To prove that I am everywhere. My servant, Prahlad, is speaking all rightly. To prove this point, Hiranyakasipu coming out from, coming out from that pillar. Satyam vidhatum nijavitta vasitam and baptincho, to prove that I am staying everywhere. Yajnavalka, one rishi, two of his boys coming back from, you know, Gurukul. Yajnavalka asking to his elder son, my boy, what is your realization about that Brahma? What is your realization about Brahma? That, you know, boy speaking so much, speaking too much. Brahma is like this, Brahma is like that, Brahma is so big. Jagavalka become very angry. Stop! Stop! Then asking the small boy, younger boy, my son, you speak out. What is your direct realization about that Brahma? What do you feel about that Brahma? Small boy, he cannot speak anything. Only looking at father with big eyes. And again, at the lotus feet of father. Again looking again. Again controlled. After some time, father blessing, my son, actually you realize Brahma. That's why you cannot speak properly. If you can realize what is Brahma, then you can become a speechless. Right you are. You realize Brahma from heart. I bless you. So he is giving big lecture. That doesn't mean he has some realization. You should have direct realization about speaking any Harikatha in front of anybody. Otherwise you are a cheater. Satyam vidhatam nijavitta vasitam and paptincha bhuteshu akhileshu chatmanaha. And he coming out from that pillar, no, not even full man, not full lion, half man, coming out. Nayam mego napi naro vichitra maho kimat kim etat nimigandha rupam. Now actually, Hiranyakasipu is just, you know, puzzle, gone man. What is that? What is he? It's not lion. Come on. Nayam mego napi naro is not full man, not full lion. Nayan migo napi naro vichitra maho kim etat nimegendo rupam. Nimegendo. Half lion, half man. Hey, Hiranyakasipu, you know, busy is in, always in tarka, tarka, no, logic. Ah, what's that? What it can be? What is this? What I see? Mimamsa manasso samuthito agrate nrisimha rupastadalam bhayankaram. Mimamsa manasa, when he is, you know, going for logical interpretation, what is that? What is that judgment? What is that speculation? Mimamsa manasya samuthita agrate nrisimha rupastadalam bhayankaram. Then the Nrisimha, you know, bhayankar Nrisimha, you know, coming in front of, you know, is very, you know, very nice, you see. It is written, you see, here, this, very minutely. Very nice. Actually, it is written, what is the, you know, appearance of Nrisimha? But how? Nice looking. irritim. Pratoptachami karachandalochanam spurat satakesharo jimritananam karala dangstram karavala chanchalo kuranta jivuham brukuti rumukho ulvanam. Brukuti rumukho ulvanam. It's like fire coming from his eyes. Pratoptachami karachandalochanam. It's like fire. Oh, big pratoptachami. Karachanda lochanam. And spurat shatakeshara jimritananam. And karala dangstam karavala chanchala khuranta juham. It's like, you know, blade. Juha as a very fine jiv. And oh, eyes like, you know, sun god. Fire coming. And you see all his face, all teeth. And this way. This way you see, big. After that you see, now Hiranyakasipu took decision to fight. What is that? I cannot understand. Half long I never see like this. Well, open his sword and started fighting. Sometime cannot see. Where is he? Where is he? Because full of light, power effulgence coming, powerful effulgence, body effulgence coming. So sometime, like, you know, here and we're going to fight. Where gone? Again fight. Oh, here. And again, sword and fight. And Hiranyakasipu was also fighting like a, you know, like a snake, sometimes playing with rat, you know, catching, living, flying, again catching, even. This way, sometimes snake, sometimes playing with rat. Ah, very nice. This way, after that, what happens? Catch him and put on lap. Here, because condition was there, I am not going to die in Bhumi, land or space. It's not spatial, you know, it's here. And Nrisimhadev now sitting, you know, not inside room, not outside, just in a border, and in a rock, just there. Not outside, you cannot say outside. You cannot say inside room. He is not using any weapon, only nail. This way, Hiranyakasipu ultimately, you know, cut with nail. And all, you know, bowels you see inside, Nariburi. And he is making mala, very nice garland. When killing Nrisimhadev, then all bloods, you know, in like you know, fountain. When cutting, then all like fountain, all blood sprinkle coming here. It's like one nice decoration. It looks nice, Nrisimhadev now. After that Nrisimhadev, you know, after that Nrisimhadev, actually, you know, killing Hiranyakasipu, now sitting in a place. And nobody can go in front of Nrisimhadev, so bhayanak roop, so dangerous. Even Brahma, Sankar, Indra, Varun, no. I cannot go. Then how to pacify the Supreme Lord? Brahma cannot go, Shankar cannot go, so dangerous. Then Brahma ultimately requesting Prahlad, my son, actually grandson, not son. Can you go in front of your Prabhu? Because actually Prabhu coming for you. This Sarup, Nrisimharup, for you, Prabhu coming here. So can you go? Prahlad said, yes. Prahlad going in front of Nrisimhadev, where Nrisimhadev is like fire sitting. Prahlad Maharaja, no tension, coming in front of Nrisimhadev. And whenever Nrisimhadev is watching a small boy coming in front of me, then Nrisimhadev's heart melt up. He takes that boy up and put him in lap. And licking. This is a licking. Yes. How to express? They are licking. Gomata, when loving the calf, when I come in front of Gomata, he is licking me. See, he is licking. Maybe love me. Who can say? It's a procedure. You know, this way. So all Rishi, all, you know, Vidyadhar, Gandharva, Charan, Yaksha, demigods, Ali, King Purush, Vishnu, you know, first you see, Brahma, Sankar, Rudra. Sankar means Rudra, Brahma, Indra. They all praying in front of, oh Prabhu. It is not the time of total destruction. Try to control your, you know, angry attitude, Prabhu. We are very fearing. We are, you know. Then after that, sapad mule patitam tamar bhakam vilakcha devaha kripaya pariprataha utchapo tat srishni adadhad karambujam. Ajay, ka bhajan kala. Kalahi vitrastro dhiyam kritavayam. Sapad moolam patitam tamarbhakam virakcha devaha kripaya pariplataha. When Supreme Lord becomes full of love, mercy, when he finds that Prahlad paying prostrated Brahmavad in front of his Prabhu, then catching him up and putting his hand, lotus hand, on the head of Prahlad Maharaj, you see. Then what to do? Uthyapo tasrishni adadad karambujam. This lotus hand Nrisimhadev putting on the head of Prahlad Maharaj. Even Lakshmi Devi not enjoying this kind of facility. Even Brahma, Shankar, Lakshmi even never enjoying this kind of facility. Never Prabhu putting his hand on Lakshmi Devi is a so much facility. Prahlad Maharaj enjoying. You see the heart of Nrisimhadev. Ugro, ugro opi, anugro. We find Nrisimhadev ugro. Ugro means? Huh? But actually, he is not ugro. For devotees, he is very loveful, having mercy. Like it is written here, like one lion, when coming in front of his children, you see, baby lion, then licking. But that lion is very dangerous in front of you, and catch and in front of everybody, lion is very dangerous. But in front of his own, you know, children, lion is not dangerous. Same thing. Sapad mule patitam tamarbhakam bilakya devaha kripaya pariprataha utthapata srishni adadhad karambujam kalahi vitrasto dhiyam kritavayam. Make him fear free. Sa tatkaras parso dhuta khila subhaha. Sa adatallad maharaj sa tatkaras sparsho dhuta khila asvaha prapadyabhi vyakto paratma darshanam. It's very. Tat pada padmam hridi nibritto dadhu hrishatanu klenno hrid asru doshanam. And you know, Prahlad, you know, become full of love and tears coming out. Cannot speak much. Voice is just choked. Prabhu loved me so much. I am an insignificant creature in this material world. But Prabhu loved me so much. He is putting his, you know, hand on my head. Oh, what to give? how to speak, pay him. They say, Prahlad Maharaj, now by the mercy of Nrisimhadev, because Siddha Swami Pad, first commentator of Bhagavatam. Siddha Swami Pad. This Siddha Swami Pad, knowing everything by the mercy of Nrisimhadev. In the bhajan kutir of Siddhar Maharaj, it is in Badrak, one place, in forest. Still that place is there. A hilly place after. One day Nrisimhadev appeared inside bhajan kutir. And putting his hand on Siddha Swami. Oh my God. So Siddharam Betti Nrisimha Prasadat. Siddha Swami knowing everything, all the meaning of Bhagavatam. By the mercy of that Supreme Lord. That's why when Ballavacharya first told, oh, I cannot accept the commentary by Siddha Saiba is very bad. What? What you say? Mahaprabhu became very angry. What do you say? What do you mean to say? Shami nahi mane tare besha madhya guni. Who is not obeying his husband, he is pros. Mahaputra. He became very frightened. What? Prabhu speaking this way. You don't obey, Swami? Swami nahi mane tare besha madhya guni. He is a pros. No place here. Then he is just... What? Yes. By the mercy of Nrisimhadev, Siddha Swami Pad knowing everything. By the mercy of Nrisimhadev, Prahlad Maharaj can speak everything. Now, by the mercy of Nrisimhadev, the small boy started chanting different sloka. Very nice. You go on hearing because time is very limited. Very with big attention you hear. 9th Adhyay chapter 8th sloka. Number 8. 9th chapter. Prahlad Maharaj now speaking in front of Nrisimhadev with folded hand. Very nicely. Brahmadayo suragana munayo atasidhya sattayiko tanagatayo vachasam prabhahai naradhitvam puragunai radhunapi vipro king tashtumarhati saume hari rugra jate. Very nice, very nice. Only here you can clean your heart. You cannot understand, I know it's Sanskrit, but you can understand by the mercy of Prabhu. Brahmadayo suragana munayo atasidhya sattayiko tanagatayo vachasam prabhahai naradhitum puragunai radhunapi vipru king tashtumarhati saume hari rugra jate manne dhana vijana rupa tapah srutau yahati yaha prabhavaval paurusha buddhi yoga naradhana yahi bhavanti parasapungso bhaktatu tos bhagavan gajajuta payo vipraddisara guna yutat arabindanavo padarabinda vimukat sapachambarishtam manne tadarpita mano vachane hitartham pranam punati sakulam natu bhurimana naivatmano pavurayam nijalab purno manam janada vidusho karuno vrinite naivatmano pravurayam nijalab purno manam janada vidusho karuno vrinite yad yad jano bhagavate vidadhita manam tachatmanam pratimukasya jatha mukhasri. This way, very nicely, Prahlad Maharaj says, Brahma, Shankar, they have so nice quality. They cannot satisfy you. And I take part in asur destiny, I am asur. How is that possible I satisfy you? So I think, big amount of property, big amount of money, dhana, vijano, I have manpower, money power, big education, from high family I am, as those all are the not reason for why Nrisimhadeva, I mean Bhagavan, can become Saraswati. Naradhanayo hi bhavanti parasapungsa bhaktya bhaktya tutoso gajajuthapayo. Only out of devotion, if you have pure devotion, that Supreme Lord like to watch inside your heart. Don't try to cheat Guru Vaishnava. Don't try to cheat Supreme Lord. He cannot do. Naivatmano bahurayam nijalabhatushto. Supreme Lord can expect nothing from you. But he is satisfied himself. Supreme Lord purnavastu. He is complete himself. Supreme Lord complete himself. He is Supreme Lord. He can never expect anything for you. But still sometimes accept him something from your flower and tulsi, everything. Why? To bless you. What do you mean by bigraha? What do you mean by bigraha? What do you mean bigraha? Bigraha, vishesh anugraha. Bhakti Supreme Lord coming in front of you in the form of deity, bigraha, to bless me properly. To give me a chance to do seva time to time. But Supreme Lord cannot talk with me. He cannot beg anything. Yeah, Supreme Lord can beg. But cannot talk with you. Supreme Lord can talk with Sanatan Prabhu. Someday Sanatan giving bread, only bread. Someday Sanatan giving only bread, you know. Actually, yeah, it's one kind of, you know, thing. And in Hindi, we say separate thing. Madan Gopal speaking, Sanatan, there is no salt. How to take? Where from I can get salt? You go and arrange. I have no time to arrange salt. Prabhu asking, no salt. I cannot take. Where from I can arrange salt? You will have to take it. So, Supreme Lord can talk with Sanatan, cannot talk with even me. Yes, Supreme Lord can talk with you. With Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Tarkeshwar, Mahadev speaking. You are going away from here to Vrindavan to do bhajan. Eh? What you are going to do for this Navadvip Dham, which just equivalent to Vrindavan, is equal to Vrindavan, Navadvip. You are not going to do any seva for this Vrindavan, in this Gupta Vrindavan, secret Vrindavan, Navadvip Dham. You took decision to go to Vrindavan. It is not Vrindavan. Oh, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, well. Now Bhaktivinoda Thakur started, you know, from all the time Bhaktivinoda Thakur doing service. Especially now thinking, oh, it is the instruction of Tarakeshwar Mahadev. Instruction of Mahadev, you cannot go. Stay here. Do the seva of Navadvip Dham. Why you are taking trouble to go there? What you can get there? What not here? Everything here. Radha Kundas, Sam Kundas, everything. Eh? I already told at the time of Gaurpurnim, ah, oh, Tirtha, we can get here. Everything. Why you are taking trouble to get plane ticket to go to Vrindavan? Why you wasting money? Eh? Yeah. Anyway, now actually, Prahlad Maharaj speaking very heavy thing. Oh, Prabhu, everybody fearing you, because you are taking such as a Nrisimha, Narahari Roop. But I don't fear. Why? Prahlad Maharaj speaking, Naham bibhemi ajitate ati bhayanakasyo jivharko netrabhukati ravasogra dhangstrad antasrajaha khataja kesara sankukarnat nirhad abhita digbhadari vinnanakhagrat. 15. Sloka. Naham bibhemi te oti vayanaka so jivhar konetra bhukuti ravasa agradam shad. He is thinking, ha! So fearful. I don't fear. But rather, I fear this material society. Prahladma speaking, Prabhu, I don't fear is this fearful attitude. But I fear this material samsara. This material samsara is fearful to me. I fear. Naham bibhemi ajitate ati bhayanakasso jivhar konetra bhakati ravaso agradhangshad antasajaha khataja kesaro kumbuk sankukaranad nirhat bhita digvhatri bhinna nagat nakhagrat trastosmi aham kipanavasalo dussahagro sangsara chakra kadanad grasatam pranitaha Trasto osmi aham kipanabasalo dusso ugro sangsar chakra kadanat grasatam panidam. Every fraction of second I am looking at this material world. The fearful situation, all fire going on. All people tending death, approaching death. They are parting with each other for self-interest. Who? Trastosmi aham, he kipanabasalo, you are showing excessive mercy on me. I am fearing this material world. I am watching the dangerous situation, the ultimate, you know, situation of those jivatma. They want to enjoy this life. What kind of enjoyment there? I don't know. Was fearful. They are fighting with each other, cutting each other, snatching money. One man taking this advantage for another. He is fighting with this, that. Oh, oof. Here in this world, Prahlada Maharaja speaking, here everybody, you see, father, mother, husband, wife, children, everybody, they are put it into problem. In shoka, you know, always crying. They are always lamenting. Ah, I am losing my son dead. Oh, my husband gone. Lamenting all the time. You know, this is the condition. That's why Prahlada Maharaja speaking very nicely. Should remember whole life, not life, this life. Infinity prayer. Yasmad priya priya vyoga sangyoga janmo shokagnina Sakala janisu dajjamana dukkhau sadam tadabidukshyam matadhiya aham brahmano brahmami badami tavadasa yogam yasmad priya priya vyoga sangyoga yanmo sokagnina sakala janisu dajjamana dukkhau sadam tadabidukshyam Atadhiya aham bhamon bhamami badami tavadas yogam yasmad priya priya vyoga sangyoga janmo. Sometime one boy taking bath, going away, mother crying. Sometime one lady, man, lover, and lady love, they become separated from each other. They are crying, lamenting on those. Nice, I can show one by one example. You can cry, start crying. You can start kind of fearful situation. One very chesty lady, very nice lady. In Orisha, this thing happened, in Bhubaneswar. Both husband and wife going to service. Wife going this office, is going another office. But every day, due to excessive paperwork, that wife become late. Every day husband become very angry. Why you are late so? What to do? So much pressure, paperwork. My boss not allowing me to go. And he become very angry. After this, he started expressing doubt. Maybe you have some illegal relation with your boss. He sees crying, I have no relation. I love you very much. No, I think so. After that, the family life break up, break family. Husband, you speaking all rubbish. Wife now crying. Now resign that service and gone to some place, lonely place. In where? Varanasi. At the bank of Ganga. Begging something and eating somehow. After that, when the husband came to know that the boss loving my wife, like sister, so much. After that he is crying, oh, my family life break down. Searching whole India where my wife is, cannot find. ultimately somehow searching Varanasi, he find my wife is now a beggar. So educated, so nice, you know, doing such service, big salary. Now crying in front of wife, please you come back, excuse me. No, I have sinned. I have seen everything, what is family life. Enough of it. I am not going back. So this way I can see 100 examples. One by one, another family like break down. They don't know. That's why Prahlad Maharaja writing, you see, is our Mahajan, Guru Prahlad Maharaja. Yasmad priya priya viyoga sangyoga janamo. Sometimes they come together, get together. Sometimes the relation crack down. They go away. You see it? Yasmad priya priya viyoga sangyoga janamo soka agnina sakala janu sudha. In every birth, in each and every birth, you are getting same thing. Why you are not getting detested? Why you are not speaking enough of it? I don't need it. Why not speaking? Why? That's why I told you, when Parikshit Maharaj asking, Atho prichyami sansiddhim yoginam param gurum purushashi hayat karyam miyamanasa sarvada. Then this, you know, Bhaktivinoda Thakur Prabhupada, everybody is speaking. It's an international question. It is not the personal question of Parikshit Maharaj. It is not the personal question of Parikshit Maharaj. We expect this kind of question to come from each and everybody of this material world. Why not coming? Why you are feeling relaxed? I am very fine in AC room. What? Foolish? Why you are in relaxed mood? Why you are not feeling pain that you are not doing bhajan? You cannot come, your life is not successful. Why you are not crying? So this question by Parikshit Maharaj, it is not any personal question. Private, it is not private question. It's an international question. We expect this kind of question to come from you all. Why you are not coming to me and putting question? Maharaj, why you are not putting question? Why you are feeling relaxed? That's mean lack of bhajan. Relaxed mood mean lack of bhajan. Yesterday, maybe 2 days ago, I was speaking. Gaur Kishore Babaji Maharaj asking to a so-called devotee, how is that possible that your wife cooking so much brinjal fry and munger dal, nice pulse you are taking? You are losing Supreme Lord, the great property. You are taking very near and nicely. You are feeling comfortable here. Your wife cooking and you are taking? Foolish. All you are gone. You are not feeling relaxed? Come on. You like to do bhajan? You cannot do bhajan. Those who are feeling relaxed, like, nice. Bank I have, you see? In bank I have, you know, 80 lakhs rupees. In bank I have 80 lakhs rupees. And liquid money also have in market. So I have no problem. Anytime I feel I have any disease, I can go and consult doctor. But come on, I can show you one by one. One by one example, you are helpless. Many times I went to Punjab, here, there, Jalandhar, here, there, so many, Jambu, is many way. At present I am not running. That time they call and I am going there, Harikatha. I knew one rich man. He is so much rich. Whenever I go, they come to attend Harikatha. So rich man. You know, one of his boy, I mean son, is crippled. His name is Amit. The disciple Bhakti Vala Tittu Vesima. Respect me, love me very much. Whenever I go, the father, I mean the, you know, he coming and drive me, go there. I told them, you cannot expect, I cannot take anything in your house. Only you can get some fruits and, you know, nut. This much is condition, then I can go. And I bound to go. You see, Now one day, Amit requesting me, Maharaj, you can speak Harikatha in our house, palace. It is not house, palace. Like king's palace. Yes, so much place, golden, you know, pot, golden and silver pot, they can offer to you for it. One day speaking to me, Maharaj, one of my sister is very, elder sister, very bad condition. He developed brain cancer. In whole world, my father and I, they offer, we can spend billions of dollars. We can give. But anyway, from America, France, Italy, England, anywhere, who can give proper treatment to my daughter? I can pay anything. But they are not getting any proper treatment. Ami speaking, Maharaj, it is all doctors speaking, it is last stage. We can have no control. Then she is going to die. Can you help? What kind of help you expect? You can speak Harikatha in our house. You can stay in our house. I can say, I told, I cannot stay in your house. Why? Because my life is an example. I cannot stay here. If at all Harikatha is there, I can go to temple and every day you can bring me here. After that, that daughter is dead. I need not speak any Harikatha. Already done. So no amount of money, deposit money can help you. No amount of deposit money can help you to come out of problem if you are in put, you have put it in trouble. So big problem, you see. This way, Prahlad Maharaj singing very nicely, you see. After that, you see. So many things. I like to speak so much, but how to speak? One sloka, if you go on explaining, it will take a lot of time. I feel very sorry. Whenever I speak Harikatha in Hindi, Bengali, you know, English, I feel sorry. I cannot speak anything. You know, all your sense organ pulling you in different direction. Palladma speaking. Jiu Harikata Ochuta Vikaru Satima Vitipta Sishna Annata Hastak Udaram Sravanam Kutaschit. Jiu Harikata Nibachan Jiu Harikata Ochuta Vikaru Satima Vitipta Sishna Annata Hastak Udaram Sravanam Kutaschit. Grano Annata Haschapala Drikka Chakarama Saktir Bahavo Sapatna Ivo Gehapatim Lunanti. 40, number 40 slope. Evam sakarma patitam bhava vaitaranya manya anna janma marana sana bhita bhitam pashano janam sapara vigraha vairamaitram hanteti paracharopi prihimura madhyo evam sakarma patitam bhava vaitaranya anna janma marana sana bhita bhitam pashano Janam sa paro vigraha vairamaitram hanteti paracharopi prihimura madhyo praena deva munayo sabhimukti kama maunam charanti vijanino parathanishtha naitana vihaya kipanana bimumukta yeko nanyat nanyam tadasya saranam brahmata anupasse. This way ultimately praying in front of Nrisimhadev. I find nobody here in this material world can save all those bonded souls. Oh Prabhu, you are the only support. You are the only support. We can believe you. Praino deva munayo sabhimukti kana kama maunam charanti vijane na parathan. All those, you know, those sadhu, they are going to forest to do their bhajan. But they are less interested about the material society. A doctor, if going to forest, what use? A doctor, nice doctor, if staying in forest, what use? A doctor better can stay in society. All people can approach. He can give treatment. So sadhu is like a doctor, big doctor. Vaidya, Baba Vaidya. He can give treatment to everybody. Why is taking trouble to go to forest? What use? Prahlad was speaking, I am not such a foolish, I am not such a, you know, selfish to leave this society and go to forest. Rather, I like to stay here to beg your kripa. I can snatch kripa from you and distribute kripa to all common, you know, those asura bhais. I like to snatch kripa. You are bound to give me kripa. Give this amount of kripa. I like to distribute among all these helpless boys. Prabhu, you are the only support. Why you are, you have to help. This way, Prahlad Maharaj giving big lesson. Only the teachings of Prahlad Maharaj, it will take big, long time. I can go on speaking about the teachings of Prahlad. What to speak about 10 sloka, 20 sloka, 50 sloka? Nothing. I feel dissatisfaction. Now, Nrisimhadeva Bhagavan speaking, hey Prahlad, I am very happy with you. Prahlad, Bhadra, Bhadram te, Prito aham te usurottama. You are enjoying topmost dignity in the Asura society. Asurottama. That means you are Asur, but Uttama. Follow. You are Asur. You take birth in Asur destiny. But still you are Uttama, you are Sadhu. Very deep meaning of each and every word. Prahlad, Bhadro. Bhadram te. He Bhadro, Bhadram te. First Bhadra mean? First Bhadra mean? Title of Prahlad. Prahlad, Bhadro, honorable title. Prahlad, Bhadro, Bhadram te. Bhadram te, I bless you. You can get all highest good. Prahlad, Bhadram. Prahlad, Bhadro, Bhadram te, prito aham te asurottamam. Now, baram brilishwabhimatam kama puro asmi aham ninam. I can bless you in whole universe. I am the only benedictor. I can give benediction to everybody. Yes. So I expect that you can beg. Get something from me. Benediction. Baram brinishya abhimatam. What do you want? Please ask. What do you want? I like to fulfill all your desire. I to bless you. Baram brinishya abhimatam. Kama purosmi aham ninam. I can fulfill all the desire of, you know, anybody, any asking in front of me. Now actually Prahladma is speaking, hey Prabhu, you are putting some lucrative offer in front of me. I am greedy. I am angry man. I am greedy man. I am full of kama. But still you are offering, Prahlad, you can take something from me. It's a lucrative offer. Lucrative offer, you know? You can feel greed. Ah, nice offer. But Prabhu, I don't any kind of, you know, thing from you. Evam pralabhyamano pi barair loko pralabhanai ekantitvad bhagavati naichatano surattama. Though Nrisimhadeva wanted to give so many things, but Prahlad Maharaj feeling, you know, saturation. Prahlad Maharaj is saturated. Prahlad, no Prabhu, I don't want anything. Though Nrisimhadeva said, hey, you ask something, I like to bless you. No Prabhu, I don't. I want nothing. Though he was giving an offer by Nrisimhadeva, but Prahlad Maharaj feel, you know, saturated. No, I don't know anything. Now, Narada Vacha, Bhakti Yogasya Tat Sarvam Antaray Arvakaha Manna Mano Rishikesan Smayamano Vacha. Prahlad could realize, if I take something from Prabhu, then I cannot get maximum benefit in devotional life. I can lose bhakti. Bhakti yoga satat sarvam antaray. It is just against Suddha Bhakti. It is just against Bhakti. Prabhu offering me to test me. Maybe Prabhu want to test me. But I cannot expect anything. Because I need only Bhakti. I need Bhakti. So Naraji speaking, Bhakti yogasva tatsarvam antaraya tayarvakaha mannamano risikesvam smayamano vacha. Then Prahlad Maharaj, with a very happy mood, speaking in front of Nrisimha, hey Prabhu, always and every day you are asking me, hey, you ask something. But I am, you know, satisfied. Ma mang prolobhayat patta satyam kamesh toir barair tat sang bhita nirvinyo mumukshastam upasritaha. I solely, exclusively take shelter of your lotus feet, Prabhu. Don't try to, and put me in trouble by this offer. Naturally, I am greedy. If you go on speaking, Prabhu, take this one, this. Sometime I can feel greed. I can accept. No. Ma mang prolobhayat patya sakto kamishu dairu. Because you know, I took birth in asura destiny. Naturally, kama, krodha, lobha already there. So you are asking, take. Sometime I can lose my patience. No, Prabhu, don't do that. I fear always about this kind of demand, you know, kama, krodha, you know. I fear, don't. At the same time, you are my Prabhu, I am your servant. You are my Prabhu, I am your servant. There cannot be any condition that you are going to me 10,000 rupees salary so I can serve you. Not that. Between you and me, there is no title, material title. Causeless. I am loving you. Why? But I don't know why. Why you, Prahlad, you are serving me? I don't know why. I love you. Why, Nrisimha, do you love me? Because I love you. Between you and me, there should not be any kind of self-interest, Prabhu. There is no self-interest, no title. I love you causelessly, you love me. That is the highest relationship, topmost relationship we have. I have. Eh? But all the time you are asking, you ask something. Well, to honor your speech, to honor you, I can do one thing. Well, if you like to bless me, you bless in such a way so that no kind of desire can come inside my heart. So, Prahlad Maharaj is so clever. Prahlad Maharaj wants to honor the speech of Nrisimha. Nrisimha speaking, you ask something, you ask, well, to honor your speech. Now I am bound to speak. Jadi dasa simi kamano. Barang stam bardar shaba kama naam hridi sangroho bhavatastu binevaram. Jodi dasasi me kaman barang stam bardar shaba. Because you are bardar shaba, bardar shaba. Bardar means those who are giving benediction, you are topmost of them. Now if you repeatedly speaking, Prahlad, you take something, takes, well, to honor you, I can speak this way. You bless me in such a way, so I cannot develop any kind of desire inside my heart. You can eradicate. So that I can never feel that I have some desire. So clever, Prahlad Maharaj is. Eh? Prahlad Maharaj is so clever. Now Prahlad, praying, oh Prabhu, my father actually going against you. And putting me in, you know, creating trouble for me all the time. But I have no angry attitude. Also, hey Prabhu, you must excuse him. My father, he was a big demon, you see. He has no bhakti, nothing. So he's doing so mischievous activities, very bad. You know, fighting with you, this, that. So maybe you are angry with him. So please, you know, excuse him. So that he can get, you know, upper plane, you can be elevated. Now, Prahlad Maharaj, Nrisimha is speaking. Prahlad, what do you think? Your father? I take him in my lap. I take him, your father, in my lap. And, you know, I tear his belly and chest. So your father, I touch your father with my finger, everything. So do you think your father going to fall down again? Whereas I touch your father. Your father is lucky and it is for you. Your kulo pavanaha. Any, you know, any family you are coming, in any family you like a devotee like you, anywhere taking birth, total 21, you know, piri. They are purified. That doesn't mean there is one nice Siddhantas there. You know, that doesn't mean in Hiranyakasipu, his father, mother, his, not that. Vishwanath Chakra speaking, that Jivatma, I mean Prahlad Maharaj actually, I cannot say that is Jivatma still. You know, he is, you know, Siddha Prahlad Maharaj and now Sadhan Siddha Prahlad, two kind of Prahlad. I can speak after, not now. I mean this Jivatma, I mean Prahlad Maharaj taking birth in any family previous. Suppose, you see, previous family, when he took birth before, that father, mother, again he took birth still before, they have father, mother, they are freed. You know, this way, you know, Prahlad Maharaj speaking, what to speak about your glories. Anywhere you are staying, any insects, lizard, cockroach, spider, anywhere you are living, all this environment become very pure. They are lucky. Yes, a Bhagavad Bhakti is so powerful, you see. Now, Nrisimha Bhagavan speaking. Acha, now question is that, why Prahlad Maharaj expressing doubt that his father not getting benefit? Good? Why? Vishwanath Chakra speaking, Prahlad Maharaj know it very well. When Nrisimha touching his father and tear, he is at the same time getting highest benefit. He is going to attain. But why Prahlad Maharaj asking this kind of question? That Vishwanath Chakra speaking, to get one certificate from Nrisimha Dev. Prahlad Maharaj knowing that my father going to, you know, get, you know, has benefit. But still Prahlad Maharaj putting question to get one certificate from the lotus mouth of Nrisimha Dev. And stamp certificate. So that Prahlad Maharaj can show in front of Sadhu. This certificate you see, I got. That's why Prahlad Maharaj giving, and Nrisimhadev giving certificate to Prahlad Maharaj. What kind of certificate? Nrisimhadev giving certificate to Prahlad Maharaj. Prahlad, Trishapta bhi pita putaha pitribhi shahotyanaga yat shadho asya kule yato bhavan vaikula pavanaha. A great devotee like you is a most pure personality. Is taking birth anywhere. You need not put question. Come on, he is automatically purified. Trishapta bhi pita putra, 21 heritage. All purified and free. Trishapta bhi pita putaha pitrivi shahotyanaga yat sadhu asya kule yato bhavan vaikula pavanaha. So nice. Prahlad, you are, you know, if anybody asking me, Nrisimhadev, how Prabhu, we like to get one example of your devotee. You like to get one example of it? See Prahlad. Nrisimhadev speaking, you are an example. You are an example in the way of devotion. If anybody asking me, we like to get an example, we like to see one vivid example, then I would say, see my Prahlad. Then you can learn so many things. Prahlad, you see. So no, this way, you see, Prahlad Maharaj now, you know, praying, and Bhagavan is very satisfied, very satisfied. That's why Nrisimhadev, you know, giving one certificate, nice. Je bhavan me khalu bhaktyanam sarvesham pratirupadrik. You know what Nrisimhadev speaking, bhavan. Bhavan means in Sanskrit, you. Honorable word. Bhavan me khalu bhaktanam. Sarvesham patirugadiv. Maybe there are so many devotees, but you are a milestone. Example. Pratirupadrip. Pratirupadrip means, if anybody like to get an example of my devotee, hey, see Prahlad. You are a milestone in the way of devotion. Yes. And you are what to speak about the, you know, benefit of your father. You are putting question about the benefit of your... Do you think your brother, your father going to fall down? Whereas I already touch him. Madanga sparsanena angalu kana jasati suprajaha. When I touch anybody, automatically he is going to, you need not put any question. Still you are putting questions, so I get certificate. I am giving certificate. Madanga sparsin, madanga sparsaninango lokanu jasati suprajaha. They can go high and high. They cannot fall down anyway. Now after that, after so much, you know, Prahlad Maharaj, now you see, when seventh canto starting, we find in front of Naraji Maharaj, Yudhishthira Maharaj putting so much question. Now we come back to this sequence. Now again, Yudhishthira Maharaj putting question to Sukadev Goswami. Bhavanu sutumichvami ninam dharmaha svanatanam varnashramacharu yutam yat pumano bindati param. Hey Rishivar, now I like to hear in details about, you know, infrastructure of this society. I mean, varnashram dharma, what is your suggestion? We like to hear. Varnashram dharma, bhavanu sutumichvami Bhagavan, Bhagavan, Satumichvami, Ninam Dharma Sanatanam. Now I'd like to get detailed information about Sanatana Dharma. And also about Varnashram Dharma, Varnashram Dharma Yutam. What is the duty of all human beings? What is the duty of wife? What is the duty of husband? What is the duty of one Kshatriya? What is the duty of one Brahmin? What is the duty of one Shudra? All we want to know. What is the duty of Brahmacharya? How they can maintain Babaji? What is the duty of a sannyas? All Prahlad Maharaj in front of, you know, Yudhishthira Maharaj. Naraji Maharaj speaking all in details. All in details. Now Naraji Maharaj started speaking. Very basic thing. Naraji speaking, He Rajan, Yudhishthira, dharma moolam hi bhagavan sarve sarva deva mayo hari. It is my first instruction. Naraji Maharaj speaking. Ho Rajan, dharma moolam hi bhagavan sarvo veda mayo hari. It is the basic thing. The Supreme Lord is the basic thing. Supreme Lord is the ultimate thing. So Supreme Lord is the basic thing of everything, dharma mool. Sanatana dharma, if you want to find out the root cause of sanatana dharma, you can find Krishna standing there. You go back and back and back and back and back, you can find only Krishna. So dharma mulam hi bhagavan sarva veda mayo hari. What Krishna speaking in Gita? Vedasya sarvai rahame bapedyo. If you go through Veda, Vedanta, Upanishad, if you don't find me, then it is useless for you to go through tech travel, to go through Veda and Puran. Or useless. You know? Now so many questions coming. Who is Brahman? Who is Sannyasi? Who is Brahmachari? How to, you know, stay in Gurudev house? What is the duty of Sriya, woman? What is their duty? So many things speaking. And Brahman, how they maintain? Samu, damo, stapo, saucham. This way giving. Samu, damaha, stapaha, saucham, santos, khanti, arjavam, jnanam, dayachuto, matmatatyam, satyam cha, brahmalakshanam. Sauryam, viryam, dhritis, tejas, tyago, shatmo, jayo, chama, brahmanateya, prasadascho, satyancho, kshatralakshanam. Deva guruvachute, bhaktistivargo, pariposhanam, and astikyam udyammo nityam naipunyam vaishvalakshanam. Shudrasya sannoti saucham seva saminya amayaya amantro yagyo hi asteyam satyam go vipurakshanam. This way varna among ashram. Now, Bhagavan, you know, Brahma speaking all in different way. Who is, you know, Brahman, who is Kshatriya, who is Vaishya, who is Shudra, and how Brahmacharya can be maintained, how to live in Guru's house. So many advice here, what to speak, what not to speak. You know, eight kind of, you know, maithun. Eight kind of different maithun. So you have no right to see. Birds and sea bird and he bird mixing, you have no right to see. Sea dog and he dog, you have no right to, you are doing brahmacharya. Be careful. No bad picture, nothing, you have no right. If you want Krishna, if you like to maintain brahmacharya, all your sense organs should be under your control. This way, you see, all the way you must be very careful to maintain brahmacharya, sannyas, to attain the highest goal, you know. Very careful. So many instructions there, I have no time to speak all about it. But I like to speak this point, is very important. Who is Brahman, who is not? How to detect? Actually, in hereditical factor, if you say, we are all Brahman in hereditical factor, I can prove it is not true. Also, who is Brahman? This body Brahman? Or this mind Brahman? Or the family member Brahman, you know, race Brahman, who is Brahman? What do you mean by Brahman? Is a question, main question. If all family, you know, heritage factor, they are Brahman, then why we find a son one Brahman, son of one Brahman, he becomes Sudra? How is that possible? How is that possible that Ajamin, losing his Brahmin position and fall down? Like a Shudra, he's, you know, taking the association of a pros, losing all his position. How Dundukari, losing his position, became ghost, going down and down in Tamajani, ghost. How is that possible? That's mean his body is not Brahman. Mind is not Brahman. Then who is Brahman? The sanskar that you develop, that is Brahman. I already told you this question is very important. Because if whole world going to hear this point, they can feel something. Javal Satyakam. Satyakam coming in front of Gautama Rishi. Ho Rishi, I like to stay in your ashram. I like to take education and instruction under your guidance. That those boys, they are taking instruction. I like it very much. I like to get, you know. Then Gautama Rishi asked him, are you Brahman? Who is your father? Who is your father? First you go, what is your identity? Satyakam going back to home, no father is there. Asking to mother, mother, who is my father? Mother speaking, I cannot say my boy. Somehow I got you. I was serving all different Brahmins and this, that. Somehow I got you. Same thing, Satyakam coming in front of Gurudev, I mean, Gautama Rishi, in front of this, you know, so many boys they are sitting there. He's speaking the same thing. Ho Rishi Var, I asked my mother answered this way, that I cannot speak your right identity. I got you somehow. Now all the boys there, ha ha ha, all boys there making joke. Then Gautama Rishi says, stop! Don't laugh! All boys, students, they are laughing. Gautama says, hey, stop! Don't laugh! It's not a matter of joking. Then they come before. Come on, my boy. You are Brahmin. You are Brahmin, number one Brahmin. How? Because you have the spirit to speak the truth. It is not possible for a non-Brahman to speak that absolute truth. Truth in front of public. So I accept you. I can accept you as my disciple. Come. You are really Brahman. Brahmane arjabu shakshat shudre anarjava lakshanam. Brahmane, in Brahman, we cannot speak a Brahman, a brahmachari, a sannyasi. They are already Brahman. They are speaking lie all day and night. For very small interest. They are speaking lie. They are sannyasi? They are brahmachari? Do you think? No! As per, you know, Bhagavad, no, not at all. For small interest, smallest interest, they are speaking lie. So it is written there, you see, you are speaking all in details in front of our public. A secret thing it is. I am 100% sure you are Brahman. You have the spirit to speak the truth. So come on, I can give you. I can initiate you. Then initiation. So Jabal Satyakam is the topmost example in our, you know. So it's the example, you see. I can give so many examples, one by one. You can go mad. In front of Yudhishthira Maharaj, Nahush Raj, he, now by the cards of, you know, Rishi, Agastadi, he take the form of python. Nahush is asking, who is Brahman Rajan? Yudhishthira Maharaj speaking, the sanskar inside of one man, and the spirit, it is actually Brahman. Brahman is not body. If Brahman is body, then we can get all Brahman in Brahman family. Why we find Agastya Muni become Brahman? Why we find, why you find there is no Vaishishta Muni become Brahman? This way, so Yudhishthira Maharaj speaking, any woman can give birth to any baby by the mercy of any woman, any man, any part of the world. So we cannot pass this kind of remark. Varnashrama dharma should be protected very carefully. Varnashram dharma should be protected very carefully. It is the instruction of Mahaprabhu. We cannot break. Daiva Varnashram doesn't mean we can act whimsically. Daiva Varnashram doesn't mean one foreign lady can, you know, marry one Indian lamb. Not that. It is not written there anywhere. You cannot give any evidence anywhere. Varnashram dharma doesn't mean that you can run your life whimsically. Daiva Varnashram means by the mercy of Supreme Lord and according to your previous sanskar, the position you are getting at present, according to that, you will have to act. In one Brahmin family, in Mahabharata, everywhere I can show. In one Brahmin family, one son became Brahmin. Another son became Kshatriya. Another became Sudra. I already told, you should have that kind of capacity, you know. You cannot understand. In fifth canto, I already told, the son of Rishabdev, 81 sons, they become pure Brahman. I told you, na? But you forget. You cannot remember. That is your disease. How is that possible? Whereas Rishabdev is Khatya? Maybe he is the avatar of Bhagavan, but Ramchandra is, you know, avatar of Bhagavan, but still he is Khatya. What to do? You see? So it is Daiva Varnashram mean, according to our, you know, nature, you know, backing inside you are getting, you have to follow. Not that you are taking birth in Brahmin family, so you are Brahmin. Not that. Who is going to explain this way? Wrong way. Who? Daiva Varnashram mean, according to your past, you know, activities, at present, by the mercy of Prabhu, you are getting this kind of nature. You know, Baba. So you'll have to do. You are getting Vaishya Baba. You have business mind. You have taken sannyas. So also you like to do some business with sannyas base? Yes. You have taken sannyas base. But you are interested to do business. Money. Who can say you are Brahman? No. Prabhupada always speaking this way. Griha Medha is there with that sannyasi. Griha Medha. This way we cannot allow this whole system to break down. We must speak right way. We must speak everything under the guidance of Bhaktivinoda Thakur and Prabhupada. To speak as it is. I have no right to change any Siddhanta. I have no right to change any Siddhanta. Who am I to change Siddhanta? I cannot change. I can relay the Siddhanta. Srauta-pantha. So the 81 sons of Rishabdev become Brahman. Nine of them become Kshatriya, Khatriya. Babaji Maharaj become Paramahansa. Those tikakar, those who are making commentator, they are doing, you know, commentary, speaking sometime, you can find raw rice, you know, atapchal. If you can keep very close place in mud pot, for a long time, 2 years, 3 years, you can find some insect growing there. Scorpio, I told you. Well, sometime we can find a Scorpio developed from father and mother, sometime without any reason coming. Vasishtha Muni, how? Dronacharya, how? One pot in which you put arrow, and that prop, drone. Here the soldiers are putting this, you know, one shack, you know, there. From there they can take. From there develop. Augustamani from pitcher. Vasishtha Muni from Urvashi. How possible? How can say who is Brahman, who is not? Who is Brahman, who is not? How to pass judgment? You can go to court to get the consent of, you know. They are foolish. They also don't know. They also don't know. You can go for court case there. The judge cannot pass any remark, having no conception about scriptural analysis. He can only speak on the basis of, you know, material thing. Ah, it's a legal thing. Only those Sadhu Guru Vaishnava, they can pass remark. They are knowing everything, past, present and future. Hey! I can discuss this point someday. This foolish society, they give honor, big honor to Ekalabhya. And decrying, insulting Dronacharya. Why he not accepting this this disciple? Why avoid? After all, why when he is successful, when he wanted to get this, you know, finger as a donation? Why? He's merciless. Why Parshuram killing those, you know, Kshatriya society 21 times? Why? Who are you to pass remark? Who are you to criticize about Parshuram? Who are you? Huh? Who are you to pass remark about Parshuram? Parshuram is merciless? Nowhere? We find all glories about Parshuram. Not only there, Parshuram is avatar. Keshavadhita Rama Sarira. What Ram? Parshuram. Dasarathi Ram after Dasarathi Ram. First Parshuram. So everywhere we find the glories of. So maybe you have some misconception about the social condition that time. About the then time the social infrastructure was totally different. You have no idea about it. So you are going to pass remark? The foolish society. They decry. Dronacharya. Selfish man. He is not giving lesson to a very nice disciple. You know, Ekalabhya. But mind it, you are situated in srauta-pantha. Unlike others. Other society, they are not staying in srauta-pantha. They cannot understand the glories of Dronacharya and Arjuna. They are so foolish. They cannot understand. I can discuss this point someday. Big discussion. Long time you can go mad hearing. Oh, very nice. We are always thinking and passing remark very like a foolish man. We have no depth about scriptural analysis, nothing. But you should accept such a guru who is having both direct realization and scriptural analysis both. Sometimes you put in question, Madhyam Adhikari. Yes, Madhyam Adhikari allowed. But Madhyam Adhikari also have some anartha, trace of anartha. But Paramahansa have no anartha. Maybe that anartha cannot put him in trouble, but still, some trace of anartha, smell of anartha can be there. But Paramahansa, no question of any anartha. But he has his right to initiate. Madhyam Adhikari can write, and you cannot leave him. His character is okay, everything okay, he is trying hard. You can take permission from that Madhyam Adhikari Guru, Gurudev. Can you permit me, I can go to accept him as Sikha Guru? Then Gurudev, no envious attitude. He can say, well, you can go, no problem. Then you can do, but you have no right to leave that Guru. Madhyam Adhikari, higher stage is very nice. Oh, Siddhanta, they can speak. Having some acharan. But Madhyam Adhikari, Kanishta, previous stage, it's not allowed. Second stage also not. Third stage is okay. You can take initiation. But also some smell of anatta can be there. Ishvare tadadineshu valisheshu disasuja prema maitri kipo peksha karati ya sa madamaha. I speak many times. Who is madam? So this way, now question, a final question, who is Brahman, who is not? Brahman is body? Brahman is family? No. Brahman is a Baba, is there inside your heart. Eh? Brahmani vicharati iti Brahman. Who is not having no connection with Brahman. Brahman means? Brahma Vastu, Krishna. Then you are not Brahman. Brahman means you should have connection with Brahma. Brahman means you must have connection with Brahma. Otherwise, how you are Brahman? You are not Brahman. You are Brahmachari? Brahmachari means? Brahmani, Brahmani, Vicharati, Iti Brahman. Who is always traveling, having his access in, you know, Brahma, I mean, Brahma mean? Not impersonal Brahma, Savishesh Brahma, personal Brahma, personified Brahma. Actually, you are Brahmachari, because you are always thinking about that Brahman, Brahma. You are Brahmachari. Brahmachari means charan, traveling. He is hovering on these topics of Brahman, even on Brahma, Brahman. So now actually, 7th canto, 15th adhyay, now Yudhishthira Maharaj, you know, Naraji Maharaj speaking, rajas tamas ca satyena sattan ca upasamena ca etat sarvam guru bhaktya purusho hi anjasa jayet. You have to defeat raja by tama, you have to defeat, you know, tama by raja, you have to defeat raja by sata, you have to defeat satagun by pure sata. All you can do very easily by pure Gurudev, Guru Seva. If you are lucky to accept a pure Guru, you can get power. Immense power you can get. You know? All you can get. Etat sarvam guru bhakta, you can cut material bondage, you can cut maya by the mercy of guru, guru bhakti, by guru seva, guru bhakti. Etat sarvam guru bhaktya purusho hi anjasa jayat. Anjasa means very easily you can conquer, you can go out of maya. It's very simple thing, very easy, but that you cannot do. If you are sannyasi, if you are brahmachari, if you are Vidyan, Pandit, if you have some kind of desire, attachment, today or tomorrow you are going to lose all your power through that whole, you know, attachment. That is called whole. It is written, asantushtasya viprasya tejo vidya tapo yaso sravanti indriya laulena gyanan chaivava kiryate. All your knowledge, all your bhajan power gathered, you have attachment, slight. For that hole is there inside your body, heart. Today or tomorrow you are going to lose everything. Everything. Through that hole. Hole means your weak point. Hole means your weak point. You are going to lose everything. That's why Naraji Maharaj speaking, asantushtasya viprasya tejo vidya tapo yaso, all, you know, name, fame, power, vidya, but anyway, he is dissatisfied always, not self-contained, always feeling dissatisfaction. For this reason, today or tomorrow, he is going to lose everything. Through this hole, he has some attachment, soul. Backdraw, lose everything. asantushta viprasya tejo vidya tapo yasaha sravanti indiyo laulena gyanam chaiva avakirjate. All your knowledge and power can go. How you can know that Keshav Goswami Maharaj maintaining full power? How? His power can speak that he is genuine. His power can speak that he is genuine. This point I can discuss tomorrow. You know, so many advice, what to speak, what not to speak. I go mad. Now I am going to enter into 8th canto. They are actually Manu Bangsha. No. Anyway, so many things there. I have no time to discuss all. Now we are going to discuss about Indradyumna Raja, who by the curse of Agastya Rishi get this, you know, get the form of elephant. Now we are going to speak about that Gajendra ji. Gajendra, Indradyumna Raja, a big king, he is doing bhajan. And the great Rishi coming here, he is not standing up, paying any dandavat, nothing. Then Rishi curse you, you are acting like an elephant. Your brain gone out of order, you are not paying respect to all, you know, honorable person. So you are going to lose your position. You take the form of elephant. Your brain is like elephant. You don't feel it necessary to pay respect. Curse. Agastya Muni. Then you fall down and take birth as an elephant in a forest. That forest is very nice. Everywhere hilly place. So nice sarovar, lake, water, all fruits and, you know, vegetables, everything available in forest. Very nice tree. Very description of that forest, if I speak, it will take, you know, big time. So nice description. Here is this, here is this, here is so nice decoration. And that elephant, I mean Indradyumna Raja, take the form of elephant now. He think I am elephant. Now getting the association of a sea elephant and getting so much children, anything. Leading nice family life in forest. Sometimes going with children here and there, taking fruits and flower and leaf. Sometimes going to take bath in lake this way, like mad, crazy mad. Not remembering what is your duty. Now here, you know, we find that, you know, Sukhdev Goswami is speaking. That in that, you know, lake, there is a nice lake. There is one, you know, crocodile, big crocodile. And one elephant will full family trip. Wanted to take bath there. You don't know that there is one crocodile. While taking bath there, enjoying taking bath, very nice. All on a sudden, that, you know, crocodile catch the leg of the elephant. Elephant shouting, ha! Elephant shouting. All wife and, you know, children, they become very sad. Why shouting? Oh, it's caught by one crocodile. Then all the family member, all the children, you know, aged, you know, our wife, they all helping that Gajaraj to get out of this problem. This tongue is like locking. One tongue is locked with another tongue is locked. They are pulling all power, they are pulling out of water. Sometimes going little out, little in. Little out, little again. They cannot come out successful. There is very, you know, big trouble for Gajendra. Gajendra now, you know, concentrating his mind how to get relief of this trap and put it in two. After long time, he could remember, well, I was doing bhajan previous life, so why not I take shelter of that Supreme Lord who can save me very easily? Because the whole universe is under his control. He can do anything what he like. Because the power of all, you know, power of all human beings, all limited power they have. You have your power, he has his power, she has his power, but all limited power. But Supreme Lord is almighty. Supreme Lord is almighty. So why not I go and pray to Supreme Lord? That's why now Gajendra could remember, I was doing bhajan previous life, and the mantra I can remember. So now in third chapter, 8th canto, and Bhadrayani Vachavadam Sukhdev Goswami speaking, third chapter. Evam bevasito buddhya samadhayu manuhridi jajap paramam japyam pragyanman sikshitam. Evam bevasito buddhya samadhayu manuhridi. He wanted to resolve this problem in heart, mind, body, you know, and intelligentsia, or like to tally. Evam bevushita buddhya samadhayo manurdi. Final settlement. The elephant could come into final settlement to jop. I can chant the mantra. Jajapo paramam japyam praga janamanu sikshitam. Praga mane previous life. Previous life he got from Gurudev. Prag janmanu sikshitam. Now he started japa. And Gajendra started stotra in front of the, oh Supreme Lord, nobody can see you. How? Gajendra is speaking stotra, but not speaking any name. Like in Vedanta, you cannot find any name. In Vedanta, only by symptom, characteristic, you can, Bhagavan is like this, Bhagavan is like this. This way you cannot get God, this way you can God. All different arguments there in Vedanta. Vedanta is fine logic. Actually, it is a transcendental logic, not material logic. In Vedanta, all the way you can find argument. Ah, this, not that, this, not. This is not that. So this way, you see, here, actually Gajendra is just speaking. Gajendra is speaking just like, you know, Vedanta. There is no name. He mentioned no name. So Gajendra Vacha, Gajendra speaking. Om Namo Bhagavate Tasmai Yatu Etat Chidatmakam Purushaya Adi Bijayo Parishaya Vidhimahi. Om Namo Bhagavate Tasmai Yato etat chidatmakam purushaya adi bijayo parishaya vidhimahi yasmin idam jatos chedam jenidam ya idam sayam yo asmad parasmatcha parastam prapadyasayam bhuvam yasmin idam jatos chedam jenidam ya idam sayam yo asmad parasmatcha parastvam prapadya svayam bhuvam. This way we can see like Vedanta. All is praying in a very, very fine technique. Only Supreme God, Lord can realize that he is calling me. But all demigod, they are, you know, Brahma, Shankar, they cannot understand whom he is calling. We can find here. All demigods come. Shankar, Brahma, maybe he's calling me. Brahma says, maybe he's calling me. Indra thinks, maybe he's calling me. But he's not speaking name, so we cannot go. We have some honor, dignity. If he's calling our name, then we can go. This way, you know, this way, Gajendra ji, doing stotra, very nice. We can discuss this stotra tomorrow very nicely, and we can go. to discuss all about the eight canto content, all everything. Now I like to finish here. If you have any question. So first, you know, first I started with this sloka. What sloka? You can remember? Naitat manu me tava kathasa vaikunthanat sampriyate durita dushtam sadhu tivram kamaturam harsa sok vayaishanartam tasmin katham tava gatim vimishamidina tasmin katham tava gatim vimishamidina Om namo bhagavate tasmai yato eta chidatmakam purushaya adibhijayo parishaya vidhimahi vanchakalpadurvasikvasindhivyavacha patitanam pavanivavishnabhyo namo namaha.